Hey everybody, this is John McCarthy from RopeSmart, and I wanted to take just a quick second to talk about our Hock Lock quick release. We have several products that most people don't know much about, one being our Hock Lock quick release, another being our Smart One 3-in-1 dummy. Most people didn't realize it had a calf head with it and they could do all different disciplines. So just recently been getting a lot of exposure with our Hock Lock. Obviously there's a lot more of them out in the industry and people have a lot more questions, so just we're going to do a real quick brief breakdown of the system, how it works, and what the benefits are. So first off, it's a solid machine piece of high-strength aluminum. Everything's machined stainless steel, welded stainless steel rings, obviously very, very strong. On and off the saddle horn, one of the best features is it's quick and easy. You can put it on in the competition pin, take it off the practice pin, put it on your kid's saddle, take it off the kid's saddle, whatever you want to do. But this is simply how it goes on. You open the strap up, put it on your saddle horn. I recommend angling it slightly to the right. You pull this around, secure the other strap, you pound it together just like this, and it's in place and ready to use. The release system for the Hock Lock is down here. It's a pull type pin scenario. The rubber hose, the reason we use this is it can be torn off, reattached if it wears out, but if your rope hits it, coil hits it, whatever, it doesn't trip your rope. Anybody who's been around quick releases has seen a tripped rope go across the arena. Obviously we saw at the World Series of Team Roping two times in the short go last year for lots and lots and lots and lots of money. So to release this, you physically have to pull up to release your rope. One of the benefits about our ring design, which I'll show you right here, it's a pear-shaped ring design. One of the things we did is that when it's in the block, it can rotate nearly 180 degrees, which means if a steer takes off to the right and you haven't released and a header says, oh shoot, I forgot you were tied on, it'll go over here, it won't bind your release and make it difficult to let go of. So it could turn sideways and you can still just pull straight up and release the ring. Okay, the reason we use a pear-shaped ring is because just in heeling, is for example, if you're roping fresh young cattle, getting off the ground really fast, moving out in front of you, when you rope those kind of cattle, you don't want any extra rope in your hands, you don't want extra slack, you don't want anything bigger than what you need, and so it's nice to be able to simply pop the rope out of your ring, slide it to whatever length you want your finished heel rope to be, and then you simply pull it back down the ring and secure it at that length. And then you just put a simple shoelace knot in it so you don't lose your ring. And insert in your Hock Lock like this, and you're ready to go rope. So roping older, big, heavier cattle, you might say, oh shoot, you know, my loop's pretty small, I got a lot of them kicking it around, kicking it out, I need more loop down there. You slide it down here, give yourself a foot, foot and a half of loop, and you pop it back in that little slot in the ring. And that's what secures it, and that's one of the beauties of this system, is you can adjust your heel rope for the different roping scenarios you're in. Another scenario that's quite common at our house is we got a couple really, really short little heel horses, and then I've got one really, really tall, lanky heel horse that's, I mean, a lot difference in height, and so it takes more rope to get to the same distance. It's not rocket science. So anyways, you can cut and braid your rope. You don't have to worry about the exact number of inches you cut it, where your knot's at, or anything else, because you can adjust this. And again, just to recap, solid steel welded stainless steel ring, insert in a fully machined and tool block, rubber handle that doesn't bump, doesn't trip, doesn't misfire. You physically have to lift to get the ring out. Also another thing too is everybody knows where their saddle horn is. You get in a wreck, you rope your horse's front foot, you need to get this, you can pull on it, things could be getting western instead of trying to find a release that's down in your horse's mane. So you have any questions, feel free to email us. Obviously it's a great system. We don't have any reports of tripped ropes and things sliding across the arena free of charge. So when you're thinking about a new quick release, starting a kid, your wife, or whoever it might be, if you're like me, you're getting older and closer to that day when you're going to be able to use one of these things, consider the RopeSmart Hock Lock. We thank you for watching today. If you got any questions, like I said, reach out to us. Otherwise, we'll see you down the road in RopeSmart.